Can't do that.
Good thing I keep a torsion wrench handy.
Huh. On the lookout. See that?
Heads up, we have company.
You see that?
I got it.
We can do this!
I'm injured.
On the lookout.
I live for the Vanguard.
On it. I've got it. Can't do that.
There. See that?
Come at me, brave meat.
Take that!
This is useless. I should try something else. Will do.
See that? I'm not entirely useless.
Damn thing couldn't pierce claw.
Will do.
I'm not.
Come and face my ire.
Interesting. Sorry, I can't.
Shh.
Sorry, I can't. I got it. I got it. Await my signal. I got it.
Send them at me in waves!
Damn thing couldn't pierce cloth.
That's a hit!
I got it. Right. Sorry. I can't.
How can we trust your rabble not to turn at this last moment? How many of your conscripts have family bonds to the Vendrian Guard? It is decided. The Disfavored will take the vanguard of the assault. It is the only way to assure success before the edict comes to pass.
Oh, you're so young. We can forgive you for being stupid. Without your Archon of Stone to bring down those walls, you're out of your element. Only the Chorus has the numbers required to swarm the walls from all sides.
The best the Chorus could accomplish would be leaving a ramp-shaped pile of corpses propped up against the walls for my warriors to use.
Another brilliant idea! Cairn's cult is, we're sure, every bit as trustworthy and sane as the late Archon of Stone himself. You did notice the spire at the center of the Citadel? Hard to miss it, being only the tallest thing on the horizon and such. Certainly your Earth mages won't do anything stupid like, say, breaking the spire's foundation.
I trust them more than I trust your circus of rapists, cell swords, and turncoat tearsmen. Tunon's Fatebinder has arrived.
You dare call the Chorus inept? Well, that's a half-truth at best.
Now that we are all assembled, I want reports. The Scarlet Chorus was going to resolve the Oathbreaker presence in the Outer Valley.
Yes, what did become of that? We should know already, yet we do not. If we are not mistaken, the Fatebinder played a pivotal role in this operation. Fifth Eye. Shed light on this baffling question.
Nothing! Curse you, motherless fucks! What have you brought but fire and
suffering doesn't really capture the nuance of what we've done. Apologies. We've been savoring this one's defiance. We know much of their inner workings, their desperate allies, their foolish hopes. This is our battle to lose.
Why I am on equal footing with Kairos's clown, I will never understand. So, Fatebinder, you would deem this mission successful? Iron Marshal. I understand we've established a foothold across the Mitanni. Report.
A most wise judgment, good Fatebinder. The Oathbreaker Captain will no doubt provide hours of entertainment. And perhaps even some usable information.
This will be just like Stalwart, when your own conscripts chose suicide over service to the Chorus. She'll be no different than the others. Petulant, uncooperative, and motivated to feed you false information. The Fatebinder is right. We argue over trivialities when we should be closing the vice on the Oathbreakers. Let us march on the double. The Disfavored will lead the charge.
You mean the Scarlet Chorus should lead the charge? Over two-thirds of your Legion remains trapped outside the valley. Only the Chorus can bring to bear the strength and numbers this assault requires. Kairos' Day of Swords approaches, and our allies in the Disfavored and the Court refuse to work with us. There is clearly only one reason for this. Graven Ash and Tunon have allied against us. You conspire to rob us of our deserved glory! You conspire to rob us of our...
To rob me of life. I struggled as best I could, but I could not shield the Legion's secrets. I'm sorry, Father.
You sick fuck! So that is what became of my son, Brennix. I knew the Oathbreakers didn't kill him in captivity. You will pay for this. But you knew this already, didn't you? Binder, I will not work with this perverted piece of garbage. And I'm a few seconds away from pretending there's no blue flag in my tent. As the voice of Tunon, you must choose which of us has the right to take Ascension Hall.
With whom do you stand?
You honor us, as I knew you would. You have made the right choice. The disfavored have stood at the forefront of battle since the first days of the war.
Our beloved Chorus! We have too many lives to protect. We can't allow your foolish decision to destroy us all!
You would dare harm me and our guest from the court? By Kairos' word, this means war! How did it come to this? Just old soldier reflexes. Couldn't be sure if it was trying a simple illusion or a bolt of fire. Either way, needed to be sure my guest didn't perish in my war tent. Yes, and instead of having false allies on our side, at least we can march on the Citadel knowing full well who is friend and foe. What other choice am I given? It is clear the voices of Narat would endanger all of us out of vanity. Besides, we all know when this war is over, someone must rule and protect the Tears. The Archon of Secrets left behind one of his spies. Perhaps we should send her back to her master in pieces. Something to say, Beric?
Nothing at present, Archon. Forgive the interruption.
You would harbor the Archon's henchmen in your company? This is aiding and abetting the voices of Narat. I cannot stand for it. The voices of Narat knows better. Of that much I can assure you. You are playing a dangerous game, Binder. If you wish to hold a venomous serpent so close, I will allow you your own self-destruction. Now leave me. When you are ready to join the assault, speak to the Iron Marshal.
You learn something every day.
Thank you. At your service, Fatebinder. What do you need? What did you have in mind?
You look as if you have something on your mind. What can I do for you?
On the lookout.